was a kid, we got a new twisty tube slide at the elementary school. Kids like to clog it up on purpose, with the kid at the bottom stopping and holding everyone else inside of the slide pipe. Some kids thought it was a riot. I felt trapped and immediately had a sense of dread. I screamed, the kids unclogged the slide, and I was instantly uncool. Was that claustrophobia or something else? Hey everyone, thanks for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. In 1879, physician Dr. Benjamin Ball observed two patients in Paris who, curiously, couldn't stay in their apartment with the doors closed without anxiety, and a third who was climbing St. Jacques Tower and felt an overwhelming urge to flee. She ran to the exit, dashing her head in the process. Apparently, the urge immediately vanished upon reaching the open air. Ball dubbed this bizarre feeling claustrophobia, and the 1881 American Journal of Insanity called it a special form of delirium characterized by a fear of closed spaces. Today, they include narrow spaces with enclosed ones in modern definitions. The list of spaces is long, including subways, elevators, rooms without windows, public bathrooms, tunnels, cars, hotel rooms, planes, and so on. And even thinking about it can trigger an attack, so I'm sorry if I did that. Most people who live with it don't get it formally diagnosed, because there is no need to do so. Their own fear causes those affected to spend much of their lives avoiding spaces that will trigger their anxiety. The National Health Service in the UK says 10% of their population is affected by claustrophobia, though studies find only about 4% will suffer from full-blown attacks. I call it an attack because psychologists and psychiatrists connect it to anxiety disorders, believing it's essentially a short-lived panic attack. It might be caused by some kind of childhood trauma, for example, losing one's parents in a crowded place or getting stuck in a hole or maybe a slide could cause you to develop claustrophobia. It's really hard to say though. Since the late 19th century, researchers have been digging into this crazy fear and found very little solid ground. A 2007 study in the Journal of Magnetic Resonance Imaging found women were far more likely than men to experience claustrophobia. And a study in the journal Cognition in 2011 found that it may have to do with the invisible bubble of personal space that we all project around us. Most people's personal space extends only as far as they can reach, but people with claustrophobia may be projecting their personal space beyond their reach. Thus, when someone violates that territorial bubble, or a wall does, the person experiences a panic attack. Researchers think this disorder may have a connection to acrophobia, or a fear of heights, as people with claustrophobia seem to underestimate horizontal distances the way that acrophobics overestimate vertical ones. Essentially, they believe the room is smaller than it really is. This study is about as far as we've come to understanding claustrophobia as a disorder. Perhaps it's a defense mechanism, and maybe some people are more sensitive to it. And it might have a genetic component as well. A 2013 study in translational psychiatry found a single mutation on gene GPM6A causes claustrophobia-like behavior in mice. Plus, a study in psychiatry and clinical neurosciences found that people with panic disorders had significantly smaller amygdalae, the section of the brain that processes fear, and they related that back to claustrophobia. In the end, they're still trying to figure out why some people experience claustrophobia. As with most anxiety disorders, there's no true cure. Symptoms can be managed, but if the phobia is severe enough, specialists will recommend exposure therapy, where the claustrophobic person would be walked through imagining and then experiencing the things that cause their fear until they essentially get over it. It's rough, but so far, this is actually the best deal we have for claustrophobia. More research is for sure needed. So I probably wasn't experiencing claustrophobia in that slide because I don't still have it today, but what do you think? Have you ever experienced claustrophobia? For more on phobias, you can check out my new hit show, Test Tube Plus, where we spend 5 episodes in a row talking about one big topic. It's pretty awesome, I have to say. I mean, it is my show. We've got phobias coming up in the series, but while you wait for that, check out our series on dreams. We talk about nightmares and why we have them, along with all sorts of other cool stuff about dreams. The brain produces electrical impulses that form waves, and when brainwave patterns indicate sleep, it's actually a different state of consciousness from wakefulness. You can actually see it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on DNews.